Welcome back to Interest Agent Training. Every single Monday, 2 o'clock Central Standard Time. And today is a hot topic because it's one of the most common things that I get asked every single day, whether it's on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, comments, emails, chat, etc. We get asked, Cody, how do I think through client rebuttals? How do I get to where I'm able to overcome client rebuttals? How do I get to where when someone gives me an objection, right? I know what to say. And if you want to think through an objection and you want to pause for a second and you say, okay, I want to ask you, what do you think an objection is? Okay, I want you to stop and think about your own personal definition for an objection, because most of us have different answers for what an objection is, okay? And I really believe that an objection is simply the client trying to take control of the conversation. Whether it's over the phone, whether it's in person, doesn't matter. I truly believe that majority of objections are totally made up, at least the first one, right? And then when they say they're not interested, they responded. They wouldn't be not interested. They wouldn't respond if they were not interested, right? Or, hey, I'm broke, right? They know everything comes with a cost. They're paying for stuff now, so they're not totally broke, because if you're totally broke, you really can't pay for anything, true? Okay, or, you know what, I didn't do that. Well, when you know they did that, and they know they did that, then they're just lying. It's just a difference of opinion, a difference of thought, right? Well, if they say, well, I already have it, you know, they wouldn't have responded if they didn't have questions or didn't have a little bit of interest, right? If they say, you know what, my spouse takes care of that, you know, that doesn't mean that you guys can't get together with your spouse. Or if they say, hey, I'm busy, they wouldn't have answered the phone if they were busy. When I'm busy, Sneaky Keithy, I don't answer the phone, bro, right? And think about that for a quick second. Stop and think. When you get a call and it's buzzing your phone right now, let's picture this, okay? When this happens, if you're busy, like legit busy, do you answer the call? No, I don't either, right? So we're past that. You don't answer the phone. I don't answer the phone either if I'm busy. Now, because if you also think about it for a quick second, if their daughter called, would they have answered the phone if they were really busy? Maybe or maybe not, but they would have answered. Let's just say they answered the phone. Would they have told the daughter, hey, I'm busy, I don't have time to talk? No, because they answered the phone, so they would talk to their daughter. They may rush the daughter to like, hey, give me some, you know, I am about to go into a meeting, but I'd love to hear what you have to say, right? But they would still keep talking to the daughter. Right? When people are really busy, they don't answer the phone. Or if their kid called, they talk to them. So with a lot of agents, and I heard it yesterday, I heard it today, I heard it this morning, with a lot of agents, those objections are paralyzing us from getting what we want. And I really believe that an objection is simply the client trying to take control of the call or the appointment or whatever. And as an agent, as a salesperson, as an entrepreneur, you typically should not listen to objections, right? That's why a lot of agents, and a lot of you, you're like, dude, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. That's why step number one is always to be agreeable when you respond, because most people aren't agreeable, and it gives you a chance to think about what you're going to say before you say it, right? So when they're like, hey, I'm not interested, I understand. And then it freaks them out. It's like, dude, no, most people don't say that, right? Most people are trained in our business to say, when the client says, I'm not interested, you should say, well, what do you mean you're not interested? You don't know anything yet. It's combative. It's disagreeable. It's stupid. And I had people used to try to train me to say that too. It's dumb. Quit saying it, because it doesn't make sense. And the client is going to get defensive, right? They're already trying to get defensive and put their guard up when they're giving you an objection to begin with, even if it's fake. Okay? So the point of being agreeable is to put it down, right? I love when I'm saying something and someone doesn't agree with me and I'm saying, hey, the sky is, you know, the grass is, oh, that grass is, you know, burnt. It's brown right now. And they're like, no, Cody, actually, I think it's green. You know what? I think you're right. I think some of it is green, you know, right? It's just, it's how we respond, how we take things. You can do this in business. You can do it in life. You can do it in an appointment. You can do it on a call. Doesn't matter, right? When my wife always says, hey babe, where do you want to go for dinner? And I say, I don't know. Well, Or vice versa. When I ask her and she says, I don't know where I want to go to dinner. Well, what I need to say next is, perfect. If you had to choose, where would you say, right? But most of us don't stop, which is why we talked about this show. That's why we're doing this on the show today, because most people need to stop and be agreeable, be positive, and get answers to our questions. So I want you to think about, when you get an objection from now on, what I want to challenge you to do is stop for a couple seconds and say, okay, what just happened? If you couldn't overcome it, then think, like, don't just keep doing that. Like, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over again, expecting a different result. When you keep getting objections and you don't eventually stop and think about what the heck just happened and how do I overcome it and how do I have better results the next time I get it? Because if you keep getting it every day and you don't get better and actually role play and train and get better at overcoming it, then it's dumb, right? We're not focused on improving at that point. We're okay with someone giving us the objection. And then we're going to blame the lead or the client or the customer instead of realizing that, hey, maybe we just aren't good enough yet. Maybe when we got that objection, we weren't prepared. Maybe when we got that objection or whatever that client said, we weren't good enough to overcome it yet. But instead of thinking of it that way, I want you to also think, next time I'll be ready. Next time someone says that, I did a poor job that time. Okay, put it behind us, right? You get one chance to make a good first impression. I'm going to put it behind me. But the next time, I'm going to realize that, hey, guess what? I got a chance to overcome that one. And the next time someone does that, if I'm prepared, if I role played it, if I'm trained, and if I know what to say and I'm quick on my feet, right? Then I've got a chance of overcoming what they said. But if we just keep assuming the same thing over and over again, we don't actually try to overcome it or get better at overcoming it, then we're just going to keep getting objections for the whole 3 years that we're in insurance, and then we're going to fail and be like 92% of other agents that fail because we didn't try to get better, or we didn't realize that, dude, when they said they were busy, they were freaking lying, right? Everyone is busy. I'm shooting this right now live with you, and guess what? I'm busy. My phone's blowing up. I'm getting text, emails, calls, everything else, but I promised I would do this, so whether I'm busy or not, I'm going to do it, right? Okay? The same thing can be said for you. You're busy. You don't have time to make dials. But you make dials because you know you need to make dials, right? They expressed interest in getting help from you because they know they need help, right? No one's, it's not human nature to say, I need help, please help me. I don't know what I'm doing, you know, Keith. I need you to teach me, okay? It's not human nature, right? Human nature say, you know what? I told you I wanted help, but I changed my mind. I'm not interested. I'm busy. You know, so stop and think about what you're doing with an objection, with your rebuttals, and how you can handle those when clients give them to you. I want you to start thinking outside the box, right? I want you to start thinking about, am I agreeable? A lot of people are like naturally like to disagree with people. There's a guy that I used to play basketball with in college, and he loved to disagree with everyone, right? And he was a great arguer. Dude should have been an attorney or something, and, you know, whatever. Shouldn't be in sales, but he was great at arguing with people. And at some point, you gotta just stop arguing with everything everybody says, because even the craziest thing they say maybe has a slight hint of truth to it, right? So instead of saying, hey, you know what, the grass is brown. Not, dude, it's green, man. I can see it. You know, you're right. I'm colorblind. Freak, it's green, right? I don't care, okay? Because if I move on, and it gets me to the next point of where I want to go, then it doesn't matter. So I want you to start to think about, what do those mean when you get them? Take a step back when it's over and say, okay, what happened? What did they say? What did I do? How did I respond? And what could I have done to make sure that next time I'm freaking ready? Okay, so I want you to pause. I want you to think about objections. And I want you to start to think about the psychology of client objections. Okay, thanks for watching Insurance Agent Training. Every Monday we come to you to help you be better. Have a great week. Get your energy up. Get prepared. Get focused. And go out and dominate. Thanks for watching.